Okay, so I'm back at the. I won't call it Kennedy, I'll call it Cape Canaveral. For now. Alright, right, back at the Space Centre. And, got a choice. I can either wait another 16 days for the next constellation A, or do I do Luna 4? I'm gonna roll out Luna 4 because I want to wait. In any case, 9 hours to roll it out, but run out to launchpad. You can roll it out, strangely enough, before the launchpad is actually ready. It's being reconditioned. You just can't launch it. All right, so go ahead. Like sunset. So we've got impact Luna 4. This is the second lunar impactor mission. What's happened now? Oh, there we go. All right, so it'll be the it'll be a night launch, will it? No, it won't be, because it's heading to the tracking station and match the phase. So I'll head into the tracking station. Tower to unbuilt to decouple before anything else, and of course I want the engines to fire up before if it lets me. What on earth? And I think the heck's going on here? Oh, thank you, right. Gonna move these down. Alright, so they're the ones in the upper stage. There's the ones in the lower stage. I need to sort these out. So I don't need to fire them at the same time. Thought about it, I thought, well, I'd rather choose when to provide eulage for the upper stage. Right, so the decoupler. Hopefully that decouples correctly. I hope. Okay, so I think I'm ready to go. The fairing. Yeah, that's okay. Right. So I'm going to pitch over this time. I'm going to pitch over. I'll change my mind. I'm going to pitch over 35 degrees. Once it's stable, roll to 180. Alright, so 3, 2, 1. Yeah, decouple that. That's the swing out of the way. So 3, 2. What the heck's going on with the. Right. Okay, so 3, 2, 1. I don't get what's going on here. They're supposed to decouple. So is the fairings not decoupling? Oh, good grief. Where are the fairings? Somewhere up here. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Where is it? Where is it? Where is it? Interstage fairing. Yeah, it's not gone. What the heck's going on? Alright. Supposed to go when the fairing goes, but when does a fairing go? I'll have to check those in the air. Just do a test on the launch pad again. I don't know. Never mind. I keep saying that. So I've got the engine burnout. I thought it was due to. Oh dear me. Something else has gone wrong. So our 79's cut out early. Got halfway through its fuel. At least I think it has. This one is supposed to be 2 minutes. Oh, good grief, I know what I've done. I know what I've done wrong. I've looked at the time after the first stage. I have an extra 2 minutes and 15. Oh, good grief, I've doubled the time. Oh, grief. I check out, I've done that. That's it, what? No. Oh, I'm gonna have to go back to the drawing board with this. Damn. No, because I built it from the top down to the bottom, so. So I went to 2 minutes and 45 seconds on that. So how much fuel it had in the first stage, supposed to. Second stage, sorry. First stage was short of 2 minutes and 15 or so seconds, so it's quite a fair bit short of 2 minutes and 45, so. Let's see what happens, I'll decouple. Ignition, that there's nothing I can do about that. See if I can make orbit, I suppose. Right, full throttle, ullage. What am I talking about? Don't do ullage like, do I? Still very stable, though. But I'm not going to trust it. Very stable. Ignition. Yeah, there's no way this has got any power. This hasn't got enough power to make it to orbit and get to the moon as well. It's impossible. Oh dear me. There's always something. Wasting the time. It's a waste of time, this. Complete waste of time. That stage cutting out early has just completely wrecked it. Oh well. Got quite hot there, wasn't it? I'll let it come down in one lump anyway. Be less sort of bits flying around. No, never mind. Got because we don't recover things, we don't learn anything, I suppose. Although I've not actually seen any evidence of that, so I'm going to do range safety, because there's no way it's going to make all, but it's got nowhere near enough path for TWR. So, three... don't need to do that, do we? Tap the backspace key. Range safety officer. Try to blow it up. Oh, never mind. Damn. Right, set it back to Space Center. Take a look in the VAB. I've got another 16, 17 dead before the next com satellite is ready to launch. So, I'm going back to Space Center. Right, so, here's the offending vessel, or vehicle. And I think it's me that's actually made the problem worse. Well, I say worse, I think I've created the problem full stop. In stage fairing, it's a fairing. It's interstage fairing, that's what it says, conic procedural. But these fairings are designed to drop away. But it lacks a decoupler. So you got to have a decoupler at the top. I've no idea what was going on there. That worked okay, that was fine. Just these decouplers did not... this decoupler did not decouple. Decoupler staging enabled. So that is a decoupler. But I'm just thinking, has it got a decoupler itself? Does it just mean it decouples the fairings? Because when you actually split these up, because these, when these fired, it overheated these. I've never put... what the devil? I never put those separation motors that far in. What the devil's going on now? Them that far in. So I think this... come on, wipe it off. So I'm thinking this lacks a decoupler. Let me just check on the payload. Is this one FB? Yeah, decoupler sold separately. I don't believe it. And if it's that one, there was a side frame to hold the part at the top. Yeah, but what does that actually mean? Right. What on earth is going... Alright. Just to make sure that I'm gonna... I'm gonna put a decoupler underneath this motor, just to make sure. Dome fairing base, that's a bit too bloody big. So I'm gonna keep locking up like this every 5 seconds. Cool point. Do you think that's gonna work? Let's put a decouple under me, that'll make absolutely certain, even when if the phones don't decouple. Don't know for I can rely on this to decouple the whole thing. Even if the phone stays intact, it'll still pull away from here. Also, I don't think launching at night is a very good idea, especially not when you're sort of launching something for the first time. It's not a good thing. It's also really not a good thing to sort of launch for a mission, just do a test launch. I suppose you can call it like that. It's a bit expensive for a test launch, though. Come on. Takes your default. Let's use that. Right. Yeah, that's what's happened. It's got another decoupler on it itself. It decoupled the fairings, but it won't. It won't decouple itself from wherever it's attached, which is a bit weird. I've never understood why they would do that. I mean, you can always turn it off if you don't want it. Sort this. So it goes into there. I'm going to create another. That. And that. And those. So I can sort it all out in one go. Oh, that's an empty node just then. Right. So that decouples. And this should decouple the fairings at the side as well. Hopefully. Seemed fairly clear, I mean the fairings did go away. But it's just this that didn't decouple from the engine. So when he's fired, it overheated this and it blew away. It burnt it up. Have that. Have that in mid flight. Right, so there, could it? Right, so that's the three main motors. Which shouldn't actually be there. So I'll put that at the bottom. And the motor just underneath the main clamps. So umbilical tower, then the motors ignite. Then the clamps attach to the motors themselves, decouple. Then. Yeah, I realise what's happened now. 2 minutes and 45 seconds. Is that on top of this? Or does it include this? Dear me. Because these only run for 2 minutes and 45 seconds. But if we're talking 2 minutes 11.7 seconds on top of the 2 minutes and 45, yeah. Oh dear, mate. There's one way to check, and just the way I just did it just then, I suppose. Undock this. Come on. No, it wasn't. So it's 2 minutes and 45 seconds by itself, so it's isolated. So that's 2 minutes and 45 seconds on the second stage. That is fine. So it cuts out halfway through. The motor actually cut out halfway through. That's not very good, that. The first stage didn't. That was fine. Anyway. I'll have another attempt. Let's make that to there. Right, there we go. Right, so Feng should be set already, so that's not a problem. If it actually lets me select something, that is. So I want a fairing. I just want a normal delta fairing. But I may, yeah, I think I might increase it to 2 just to make sure it splits, because we don't have any hollow interstages yet. Where the devil's it? I can't quite see that. Not two of them. So I want the height to bring him back. Come on. Take all year. That should do. Alright, so we just submitted off. Because we've disabled, decoupler staging enabled. Decouple when fairing gone. Yes. Well, it's not doing that, is it? Decouple on the fairing gun, it's not doing that. So it's not decoupling when it's supposed to. Because the fairing wasn't amongst them. There we go, I thought that's what was going on. Right, so we'll put this, these two, into here. That's what was wrong, it's a fuselage fairing. So it's locked, we'll actually decouple. Right, so that's in there, that's in there, that's in there, that's fine. Good grief. There's not a great deal of explanation as to what the parts do or anything else in the descriptions of any of these. Same as, I mean, like I said about re-entry. Re-entry with the service bays, I mean, forget it. Because just through convection heat, that's heat through the air, or through contact, there's no way it's going to survive because it's only made of aluminium. But it doesn't tell you that. It might say 1000 degrees Kelvin, but it will reach that temperature far faster than a heat resistant material. Which will have exactly the same melting point, but it will resist heat better. And that's something else it doesn't actually sort of make you aware of. That's better. That's a bit cleaner as well. It's not bad, that. Hopefully it won't blow up in midair. Although I did that. Another 17 days, so I'll do these. I'll do another ComSat launch. Just check that. Yep, that's that. Then I can choose when to actually fire the Ulage motors for the second stage. Hopefully that doesn't cut out. So basically that was halfway through its burn. There's about half of the fuel left. Maybe just under half. That's the biggest kick you need because it was above the atmosphere. Right, I'm going to make one single attempt again at this with this launcher until I actually take a more of a sort of look at some alternative engines, maybe. So first for the second stage, so it bends a little bit more effectively, a bit more efficiently. I mean, that again is a fair effect. That's LS79 again, but it's just a different sort of appearance. It's the MB-3. But, oh dear. Well, that's not bad, 421. 758 there. Alright. I think that was the problem. Well, it must have been the problem because the fair wasn't actually didn't have a decoupler on it, so it didn't appear in the actual staging list. All right. Well, learning all the time, I suppose. 91. There's no real sort of alternatives that are sort of within the same sort of power range except for that, RD253, but that's actually not bad. But it does require eulage. How many ignition is it? 2 minutes and 28 seconds. It's only got one ignition. Then again, this has, but this up here has, and this has. But regardless, 2 minutes and 45 beats 2 minutes and 28. Yeah, I'm using the top version we've got, an A13. Ah, D. So I've used it enough times to get some more data. So I'll use that. Not surprised I'm using it for first and second stages now. Alright, so, alright Luna, 17 days. Technically it's probably not going to be 17 days, it'll be even a few more weeks. Alright, let's head back out.